In 1964, ConMet was founded to solve Freightliner's challenge of making trucks lighter. Starting in Portland, Oregon, the company quickly established itself with innovative aluminum castings, sparking growth and expansion. Later, ConMet transitioned to independence, serving a broader market and attracting new investors. This independence drew the attention of Varlen Corporation, whose acquisition fueled further growth and innovation. As the company continues to grow, visionary leadership and bold innovation will drive ConMet to redefine industry standards and forge new paths forward.
We wanted to make ConMet more of an engineering, technically capable company where we could go to customers and not be a foundry, but being looked at a parts supplier that had it all together and could do the job if they needed.
So ConMet under Varlen was a very entrepreneurial, progressive, fun company. We always had money for investments. We were growing. It was a great time.
Well, there were a lot of things happening in the 90s with heavy trucks, and one being that the maintenance council was pushing manufacturers to have vehicles that could be warranted for 3 years, 350,000 miles. And part of that was to have wheel ends that lasted longer.
Wheel ends in the early days were purchased from ConMet or other suppliers, and they came with a set of bearing cups and some wheel studs and the hub, and that was the product. The OEM was having to buy hubs, seals, and bearings, so three different suppliers to put things together.
The thing we had better than anybody was the housing, because we could make the housing, but then we could develop all the bearing system within the housing and control the seal and everything else.
But for ConMet, that was pretty novel thinking that we were going to put bearings in there and gonna make something that was already pre-adjusted. The development name was IWE, Integrated Wheel End.
It wasn't any one person, it wasn't engineering, it wasn't sales. It was a collection of management that said, hey, here's an idea, let's try it. And we were not afraid to try things, and if it didn't work, then we'd try something else.
And the benefit to the OEM was they didn't have to deal with as many parts, they just dealt with a preset hub from us.
Nobody understood it at the time, customers weren't interested at the time, they were still assembling their own wheel ends back then.
It was a lot of work, we had to get the service manual out every time, there's a lot of adjustments, trying to fumble, holding the bearing up. It was a lot of additional steps, and then when we got to preset, it was great, we were all blown away. Wait, we can just throw the bearings in, we can put the spacer in, we just torque it to like 300 foot-pounds and we're done? No way, that's too easy.
There was a choice that the industry had to make on how to optimize the wheel end technologies, and we won that battle. To me, that's the largest milestone because that's, you know, stabilized us as the leader.
It really strengthened our reputation with our customers to where we become their most trusted partner in that area of the truck.
As preset technology revolutionized the commercial vehicle industry, ConMet's journey took a transformative leap in 1999. With Amsted Industries' acquisition of Varlen Corporation, ConMet joined a powerhouse of innovation and collaboration.
When Amsted acquired ConMet, it was a very challenging and uncertain time.
As we were going from a publicly traded company to an ESOP, and me included, nobody knew what it meant.
It's a really special structure where ownership at some point in a company's journey was transferred to the employees. In Amsted's case, we used to be publicly traded. And in the 1980s, in order to avoid a hostile takeover attempt, the employees and management took out a loan and took the company private. And then about 15 years later, the employees did the same thing, where they took out a loan to buy out management, making it a 100% employee-owned ESOP. And today, Amsted's one of the largest in the world, and it's a really special structure.
Every non-bargaining person in the company has ownership in the company. That really installs a nature of, hey, I'm a shareholder in this business. This is an important business.
At that point, they had hired a really smart CEO named Bob Rehm.
He turned everything around. He brought in the idea of innovation. He really focused us on innovation.
I would say that we gained even more focus on strategy regarding being more challenged. ConMet was doing well, but I think that extra challenge helped take us to a higher level.
You know, I think from the origins of ConMet, how much of a kind of a family type culture it has with really digging our heels in and solving problems, I think that only advanced with the Amsted and the ESOP.
It's really an ownership mindset, or what our CEO, Steve Smith, calls it, the spirit of ownership. This is our asset. This is our sales. These are our customers. We have to keep our customers happy. We have to keep them coming back. We have to keep them growing, because at the end of the day, if we do, That's our money, that's our sort of wealth we're generating for ourselves and our families and our colleagues, and that's a really powerful thing.
I think that gave a tool that allowed more people to participate in the success of the company, and I think that was pivotal toward the growth and the success that we had.
Under the visionary leadership of President Ed Olchin, ConMet not only secured its dominance in the wheel end market, but thrived by putting customer needs at the forefront, sparking remarkable global expansion.
Our expansion really is a result of the truck OEMs expanding, and you know, we like to go where our customers go.
So we had some of our OEM customers were already establishing operations in Mexico. Ed, in his wisdom, was looking at where the future may be. If the customers, our OEM baseline grew, how could we accommodate that? So we said, we gotta get land.
It was our first time entering into Mexico, but we knew we had to be there to support our customer.
And we got other customers too, also Navistar and PACCAR's got their facility and so forth, and now Volvo is coming to Monterrey.
It is a world-class manufacturing facility making all three of our core products, and it is absolutely the best in the industry.
What ConMet did for Mexico was that we brought the opportunity. What the people brought is a strong work ethic, seeing the will of the people and knowing that, you know, not only is ConMet succeeding, but our people are succeeding.
As our market share grew and as we looked at, you know, our place in the market, our customers saw us as a trusted partner in the wheel end space. And for us to be truly a full service wheel end provider to the market, we couldn't just be an aluminum supplier.
Customer comes to us and says, we need to not be, you know, tied to this supplier anymore.
We have the decision to make. Did we want to enter the iron hub market? At that point, if our customer needed a hub, whether it was iron or aluminum, we could provide both solutions.
And in 6 months, we had all brand new parts developed and delivered. And that really kicked off our business.
We could not get enough of those components here in North America from other suppliers, so we decided we needed to do it on our own.
With Preset firmly leading the wheel end market, ConMet remains committed to innovation, introducing the next evolution of Preset to drive value for our customers and uphold our mission of delivering premium, forward-thinking solutions.
We ran with Preset for a long time.
But we still had problems in the field. We had problems with spindle nuts. There were four or five types out there. You know, we finally decided that, you know, the spindle nut was our next biggest problem that we needed to solve.
We got a lot of input from customers when we were starting to look at spindle nuts and what people liked about them, what people didn't like about them. A lot of the OEMs wanted to use spindle nuts that were complicated to use, required special tools. We developed a spindle nut. You could torque it to a set torque and lock it in place without any special tools, and that's what became Preset Plus.
ConMet's Preset Plus, with the integrated ConMet spindle nut, further simplified the hub installation process and solve the later life service challenge of cone race rotation.
Once you see it all done, it's like, oh, well, that's the obvious answer. But it wasn't the obvious answer as we ground through it.
It sped up the process. It made it a lot cleaner because we could build the whole hub assembly. We could guarantee that it was put together properly and going to be installed without damaging any extra components. The seal always went on dead straight.
Throughout its history, ConMet has remained dedicated to solving challenges and putting customers first. In the next episode, we'll explore how this commitment continues today, with a focus on groundbreaking innovations, sustainability efforts, and the relentless drive to push the boundaries of what's possible in the commercial vehicle industry.